For depth only there is a difference, I told you. It is height, what happened, whether you from the surface of the earth or away from the surface of the earth, the whole mass of the earth is involved. But in case of depth, what is happening, suppose you see the earth, the point I have taken A, A is on the surface of the earth. Okay, so another point you can take inside, suppose this point I am taking, the point B. So what is the depth here? D. Okay, so here the R, radius of the earth, M, mass of the earth. Okay, now two different points. In case of height, what you do? One point is on the surface, the another point B is at is somewhere height. So when you take at A or any other point, the whole mass of the earth is involved for gravitational force. Because in gravitational force, which one plays the major role?
Mass of the earth.
Mass. Okay, the mass plays the major role. So once you are on the surface or away from it, the total mass is involved. So that's why there is no problem. But in case of depth, you see. Okay, so first I am going to take at A. At A, what is the acceleration due to gravity? When I am taking at the surface, the total mass is involved. So small g equal to gm by r square. Okay. Next, what is happening? You come to the point here, B. When you come to the point B, what is happening? This much portion, okay, should be removed. You see that. Suppose only this you have to take. So this is how much? R minus D. What is the mass? M? Mass is M or something different? Different. Because this much portion is removed. So it will be, suppose, M dash. Now two factors are coming here. Suppose G dash equal to G M dash here R dash square. Try to understand that. So the mass is changing, the size also changing. So now two variable means difficult to do the calculation. That's why we want to convert into one variable. One variable. For that, what we do here, previous also same thing. Previous that variation of G with the height, only R was changing. Suppose R, R plus H, okay, like that. M was same only. Here M, the second equation also M. But here what will happen? M is changing. Distance also changing. That's why now you want to convert into 1. So in terms of density, how to do? Mass equal to volume. Volume into density. So G by R square. What is the volume sphere? No, 4 by 3 pi r cube into density, density rho. But what we do here, the density we take it uniform, whether it is on the surface, whether at center. But you know that there is a variation in the density also, but we assume that density remains constant. So rho. Now you see r square here, 1. Which is equal to 4 g pi by 3 rho, rho also constant into r. That's all. You see that now whatever quantities within the bracket are constant. So which one is variable? R. Only size is variable. So m factor is not there. Now it becomes easier. One variable system. So at A, what is the radius? R over. Next, what do you want? At B. At B means depth. Depth D. So G D. Visible? Yes. Equal to 4 by 3 G pi rho. What will come instead of R?
R minus D.
R minus D. That's all. R minus D, equation 3. Acha, those are attending from home. Okay, what about today? The video?
Sir, clear.
Clear, okay. Okay. I think you got two equations. Now what you will do? Yes, equation 3 divided by 2. 3 divided by 2, GD by 2. D is what? Depth. So
GD by G equal to
this one. See, whatever quantities within the bracket, it is I am removing, otherwise you will have problem. Okay. You see here, 4 by 3 G pi rho, 4 by 3 G pi by rho, so cancelled. So
R minus D by R. So what you will have? GD equal to G into 1 minus D by R. Equation 4.
Equation 4. That is the final formula. So this is for with
the altitude. Altitude. This is with depth. Try to understand. So this is the equation you are writing.
Yes. Once again, I am repeating. What is the topic? Variation of G with the depth. Yes, we know that small g is not a constant. So it is a variable. So now with respect to depth, how the G varies. Okay. So what you have done? Yes. First, you have taken one point on the surface. If it is on the surface, the G, small g almost constant. How much? Gm by R square. Next, what happened? Instead of using M and R, why we are changing? Because once you go inside the earth, you come to this portion only. So only this portion of mass of the earth is involved. The remaining portion is removed. That's why M is variable, R also variable, because you are coming inside. That's why we want to convert into one variable system. So for that, we are converting mass in terms of density. Okay, mass equal to volume into density. Volume, the earth is considered as a sphere. So volume of the sphere, 4 by 3 pi r cube into rho. Rho is what? Density of the material of the earth. So what we assume here, density remains constant. Okay, whether it is on the surface, inside, center, okay, practically no, but certain thing we have to take assumption. And then you, so now you see the G in terms of size only, mass is not there. Okay, so it is on the surface R. If you go inside, the size will be R minus D. I have put it here, R minus D. Okay, so here R minus D, and then simple, okay, equations, okay, you are getting. Now you see, as the depth increases, what about the GD value? This portion copied, ma? This is copied, no? Only here, huh? Yes.
So GD equal to G into 1 minus D by R. What is D? Depth. From where you have to measure? From the surface of the earth. Very, very important. Surface of the earth.
What is H?
Height. From where? Yes. Surface of the earth. Very important.
So whether it is the height or depth, always measure from the surface of the earth. If you want to measure from the surface height, if you want to measure the depth from the surface inside. Okay. Now,
suppose I'm making that as the D increases, as D increases, what about GD value?
Decreases. GD value decreases. Okay.
Second point. Now, what is the decrease in G with the depth? How much you have to, how much will come? D by R.
Okay. Now, third, percentage. Percentage decrease
is in G with the depth. Here, D by R into,
yesterday I explained, no? Change in value upon original value into 100. You put it, you will get. Change in value upon original value, simplify, you will get D by R. D by R.
Okay, so what is the change in value? See, change in value by original value. G minus GD by G. It is nothing but 1 minus GD by G. 1 minus.
What is GD by G?
1 minus D by R. That's all.
Check it. Change in value upon original value. That is a decrease in value. How much value decreases? Suppose you want percentage error, multiply by 100. So the error analysis, you write, it is a very general concept. Whenever you want to do for any physical quantity, always remember general change in value upon original value. If you want percentage error, multiply by 100%. That's all. Okay. So 1 cancel, minus into minus plus. So D by R. That only we got D by R. Just to copy it. One more I want to put, fourth point I will write here. Wow. Yes, all of you copy?
Yes, sir.
Because always we receive the complaints, sir, nobody bother about us, we are sitting at home. You also felt like that? Yes, I will tell our teachers also. Naturally, what happened when you are present, you focus on that. Okay, it takes time. Okay, I'm trying to balance both. Okay, some are facing problem because the teacher also told. Okay. Anyway, we'll do that. Because it is complete teamwork. Okay, whatever the difficulty you face, whatever there, you have to tell so that we can rectify it. Okay. So now the fourth point. So what will be the acceleration due to gravity at the center of the earth? At the center of the earth. So what is small d? Not small d, which let us see that. Okay, suppose this is d. Okay, this is R. This is R minus D. Okay. At the center of the earth, what is the formula? GD equal to G into 1 minus D by R. So what is the value of D?
R.
D becomes?
R.
R. R. So what is GD?
Zero.
D is R. So, 1 minus 1, 0. So, 0. So, anybody want 0 weight? Yes. If you want 0 weight, where you have to go?
To the center of the earth.
Yes, center of the earth. You go just, okay, how to go? I'm giving the technique. Okay, this is the earth. Okay, then you drill it. Okay, then you'll be here. Okay, this is the portion. You will get zero weight. Anybody want zero mass? Even if you want that is not possible. Yes. So weight can be, because mg is the weight, so weight can be brought to zero but not mass. Any other place the weight can be zero? We say weightlessness. No, equator it will not be. When we, yes, far away from the earth, infinite.
Sir, when distance. We sir, when we go r distance from the earth.
Yes, when you move r distance, okay, that you can check it. Or when we fall freely under
gravity.
Gravity. Because when we fall freely, you assume, but don't do that. You are standing on the height of the building or tower, just you jump, because you don't get any experience of any experience to people. You won't get it back. So when you jump, what happened? Free fall. So, because why we feel our weight? Because of the reaction. Because I am standing on the horizontal surface, how much weight I am exerting? Mg. How much reaction I am getting? Mg. That's why my weight is Mg. Suppose if it is inclined surface, when I am standing on the inclined surface, what is my weight? Very good, mg cos theta. Now the weight is reduced. So which one feel our weight? Because of the reaction. So when you fall freely under gravity, you won't feel any reaction. Internally some reaction I am not talking, but some force would be there. Reaction is nothing but force, no? So you won't feel anything. So it becomes zero. That's why astronaut feel weightlessness. Astronaut in the orbiting satellite, no? Because that no reaction will be there. So when there is no reaction, the no apparent weight is zero. One topic I discussed with you, I think. Apparent weight of your body in a moving lift. Remember? So when the lift gets accelerated downward, upward, and the lift mechanism is failed and falling freely. Okay, the same question can be applicable to monkey also. When the monkey climbing on the rope, when the tension will be on, all the things. All are same topic related to the reaction. Okay. I think this is also clear. Okay. Yes. So the main topic, these two topics are over. One is with the depth, another one is with the height. One more thing I am telling those who are attending from home. So when you send the some message, that is the chart message, typing something, definitely the teachers are not in a position to see. Therefore, now roll number 218, Prakash already given the answer space. Okay, but I am telling the teachers not in a position to read your message. So only you can hear your voice. Please, you give voice message only. Okay, even class 9th and others told, sir, so many answer we are giving, no teacher is responding. Now also I randomly checked, one answer was there. Okay, please don't do that. So give voice message only. There is no alternate for that now. Okay, anyway, so all the things are over. So for what we had done about the gravitation, gravity, after that we got the formula for acceleration due to gravity and how the small g varies with respect to shape of the earth, height and then depth. So where the value of small g is maximum?
At the surface of earth.
At the surface of the earth. So if you move away from the surface of the earth, away from means whether from height or with the depth, the g value decreases. So once you go inside the earth, the g decreases. When it comes to at the center of the earth, what will happen? The g becomes zero. But whether possible or not, means so many factors are there, because once you go inside the earth, the temperature become very high, no? So these are the thing. But otherwise, if you remove other factors, whether what is the practically happening, that we are calculating. Okay, otherwise certain limitation we have. Yes. So now the next part, what we are going to discuss, gravitational potential energy. Before discussing gravitational potential energy, we should know what is gravitational field. Force already you are knowing. So what is gravitational field? And then we discuss about the potential energy, gravitational potential. Okay, that will be the second part. After that, we'll go for the what? Satellite, or orbital speed, escape speed, all the things. Okay, I think Kepler's law they removed it. So we'll do after that. Yes. So already you are knowing, suppose you have the mass is m, okay, you make it m1, m2 also, no problems. Another one, m2, the distance r. So what is the gravitational force? You tell me, g, m1, m2, r square. All around. This is gravitational force. The weight is nothing but gravitational force. How? F equal to G. Suppose you have, this is the earth, mass M, you are here, or you are just here, no problem. Okay, mass M. Suppose the distance is almost equal to capital R, because very close to the earth. So G, M,
upon
capital R square. What is GM by R square? Small g.
Yeah.
So it become mg. So what is gravitational force? What is mean by weight? Weight is nothing but gravitational force. Which one exerting gravitational force on you? mass mass of the earth. So earth exerts the force, which direction? Downward. So that's why what happens, we are attracted towards the earth. So the apple is falling upward or downward?
Downward.
Downward, towards the center of the earth. Then how much force, suppose F is the force exerted by the earth on the apple. How much force exerted by the apple on the earth?
Sir, same as this.
Yeah.
No displacement.
Who is moving? Apple is moving towards the earth, no? Then why not earth towards apple?
The apple's mass is negligible as compared to the earth.
Which factor is playing here, the difference?
Mass.
Yes. So now when you talk about acceleration equal to F mass upon F by F, right? You see that? F is same. But acceleration proposed, if I write M, you will get confusion. So I am writing mass. It can be anything. 1 by mass. You see that? So when in case of earth, the mass is much heavier, 6 × 10^24 kg. 1 upon 10^24 kg equal to almost zero. So what is the acceleration on the earth towards
zero?
Apple? Zero. Practically not zero. It has something, but negligible. But apple, how much? Maximum you can take it, 250 gram. Okay. So 250 gram means you have some significant value of acceleration. That's why the apple is moving towards it. Okay, is it clear now? Force will be same, but acceleration different. Acceleration depends on the mass of the body which is to be accelerated. So the earth also accelerated, but very, very small, negligible. That's all. Okay. Yes, come to this topic. Okay, gravitational field. I'm writing the symbol E, no problem. Okay, so what is gravitational field? Now suppose you are here, this is the mass, this mass I am taking M. Okay, suppose any test mass you placed here, this is what? Test mass. Now what happened? This mass M produces field. See why we feel some interaction, something, because of the some field. Suppose you have one magnet N, yes, then if you bring any other magnet, then there will be a what? Attraction here. Interaction between them. Why? Because no physical contact. Between the two magnets, no physical contact. But some field is acting. What is that field? Magnetic field. Same way, if you keep any material, around that material, field is acting. What is that field? Gravitational field. So because of this field, we have some attractive force. So we don't have any physical contact, but still we are attracted towards each other. The apple is attracted towards the earth because of the gravitational field. So what is gravitational field? So the gravitational field equal to F by M. This is the formula. What is here? What is F? G, M, test mass M naught upon R square. Okay, into 1 by. Clear? So what is F? This one. So M naught cancel, which is equal to Gm by R square. This is what? Gravitational field. So gravitational field, how to measure? Mass of this body, not test. And the distance for where? Suppose if it is easy, E proportional to 1 by R square. As R increases, what about gravitational field? Decreases. That's why when you go to infinite distance, what is the gravitational field?
Zero.
Zero. You won't feel anything because the distance is infinite. Infinite mathematics, there's no infinity. It is nothing but very large value. The concept is that meaning. Very large. When it is very large, the field almost zero. You will not get any interaction. So that's why whether it is there. See, next year what happened? You will read electric field, magnetic field concept. Here you are reading gravitational field. But the concept, no change. Only the name may be changing. We use electric, magnetic. So whether it is electric field, magnetic field or gravitational field, at the infinite distance, the interaction is negligible. Is it clear now? So what is, see, what is the unit of force?
Newton.
Newton. Mass?
Kg.
Kg. So Newton per kg. Okay. Gravitational force is vector or scalar? Vector. Vector. Any force vector. Automatically field also vector. Vector. What is the direction of gravitational field? Suppose I'm giving you. Suppose this is the mass. You want at this point P, r distance. Okay. Then what is the direction? Towards. Because in electric and magnetic thing, no, you can have towards, for example, electric field. Towards or away, because positive or negative you have. So if it, okay, if it is like towards, opposite, ripple force, then away. But in gravitation, that is the only difference. In gravitational field, it is always attractive. Always attractive. That's why any point you want to find out the direction of gravitational field, it is towards the mass. It towards the center of mass. That is the difference. So the direction of gravitational field is towards the mass. So this, what is this? This is source. Source mass. This is what? Test mass. In the formula you see, you will not get any test one. The test one can be anything. You place the particular thing, how much force you're experiencing accordingly. Okay. Which strength you are going to measure? Source mass strength only. Simple way I'm telling. Suppose you have one electric charge. Now I want to find out how much electric field strength is produced. So what I will do, this is the source charge. Now you are the test charger. So I will keep here. How much force you are experiencing? That much. Suppose you are experiencing less force, the strength due to this charge is less. You are experiencing more force, okay, then the field strength due to this charge will be more. Clear now? So we are not talking about the test value. Test is almost negligible. We don't bother. Very, very small mass we take it. That is for test purpose. But whatever you measure for, this only, source. So what is gravitational field at a point? The gravitational force experienced per unit test mass placed at that point. When you are going to keep the unit mass at a particular point P, how much force experienced by that mass? That will be the strength. This is the formula. From here, easy to define. Definition. It is defined as gravitational force experienced per unit test mass placed at that point. Placed at that point. Is it clear now? It is a vector quantity. If it is vector quantity, means what is the direction? Towards the mass. Towards the which mass? Source mass. Because it is always attractive force. That's why towards. Suppose any other thing, if you have repulsive force, away from it. That's simple. Okay. Please note down all the thing. Okay. Just okay. I'm giving that the.
find out net gravitational field.
There are two masses. It is not a test mass now. I am not done. So there are two masses are placed with a separation 1 meter. Okay, 10 kg, 5 kg. What will be the net gravitational field?
Okay, suppose O. You see that at 2 O.
Now how many gravitational field you will get at 2 O? 2. One is due to 10 kg, another one is due to 5 kg. Whenever mass is specified, you don't neglect, you don't take it as a test. Okay, how many masses are there? The same number of field you will get. So due to 5 kg, okay, you have two forces. You tell me, due to 10 kg, suppose you make it 1 here, 2. So E1, E2. Where E1 will act?
Towards
10 kg. So here you have E1. Where E2 will act? Towards
5 kg.
Yes. E1, E2, how to find out? What is the formula? Gm by R square. Suppose E1, M1, R1 square. M2, R2 square. Anyway, distance is total distance. How much given? 1 meter. Then what will be the value of R1, R2? 1 by 2. Okay, so distance you are knowing. M1, M2 you are knowing. Find out. E1 you are knowing, E2 you are knowing. How to find out E net? Very good. Why? Gravitational field is vector quantity. How they are acting? Opposite direction. When they are acting opposite, what you will do? Subtract. Same direction, what you will do? Add. Suppose one mass is here, another mass is here. I want this point. What is the direction? Here, what is the direction here? How these two are acting? Perpendicular. How to find out? Suppose this is E1, this is E2. So what is E net? Very good, ma'am. Very good. So E1 square plus E2 square plus 2E1 E2 cos theta. Theta 90, cos 90 0. That's all. That's why I'm telling any question. Which chapter we are using here? Vector chapter. Vector is that much useful. When you go to next year, maximum topic, maximum physical quantities are vectors. Very useful. That's why I'm telling, don't stick with a particular case. You make it general idea. Vector quantity, take a vector process. Square root of a square plus b square plus 2ab cos theta. Apply everything. Okay, you solve it this. Like that one or two question, you take yourself, number, the distance, mass, undo yourself. One or two questions. Okay? So I think now the okay. So let me take the attendance. Yes.